Good morning. In our last period, we have discussed various types of production function. In our today's period, let us try to estimate the production function with the help of some examples. Firstly, the linear production function. In my last period, I have told you that linear production function can be written like this. Y equal to A plus BX, where Y indicates total output, A is a constant parameter, B indicates rate of growth, and X indicates quantity of inputs used. If A equal to 10, B equal to 4, and X equal to 2, then Y, that is total output, will be equal to 10 plus 4 into 2. 10 plus 8 equal to 18. 18 will be the total output which can be produced. Then second is quadratic production function. Quadratic production function can be written like this. Y equal to A plus BX minus CX square. If A equal to 20, B equal to 5, C equal to 2, and X equal to 2 once again. Y equal to 20 plus 5 into 2 minus 2 into 2 the square. 10 plus 20 plus 10 minus 8. 30 minus 8 equal to 22. 22 will be total output. Then cubic production function. Y equal to A plus BX plus CX square minus DX cube. If A equal to 15, B equal to 6, C equal to 8, and D equal to 4, and X equal to 2, then Y means total output is equal to 15 plus 6 into 2 plus 8 into 2 square minus 4 into 2 cube. 15 plus 12 plus 32 minus 32. 32 cancels. 15 plus 12 means 37 will be your total output. Then power production function. Y equal to AX raised to B. A equal to 30, X equal to 4, B equal to 3. Then Y equal to 30 into 3 raised to 4. 30 into 81 gives you 2430 as your total output. So these are different types of production function. And output can be estimated by using different levels of inputs like this. Now let us study. The short-run production function with the help of the law of variable proportions. Law of variable proportion. This law analyzes the short-run production function, that is input-output relation in the short run. In this law, let us study the statement of the law. Then, various assumptions of the law, significance of the law. I will give you input-output schedule. Let us draw total production, marginal production and average production curves and their relations and different stages of production. So firstly, statement of the law. What this law states? The law of variable proportion is an important law of production. It is also the fundamental law of production. And it is a universal law of production. Why it is a universal law? It is a universal law of production because this law can be applied to almost all production fields. It may be the agricultural sector, industrial sector or service sector. So this is also applicable to the mining activities. Agriculture, mining, industries and service sectors. In all these sectors, we can apply the law of variable proportion. What this law states? This law states that when other things being equal, when we vary different factors of production in variable proportion by keeping one factor constant, after a stage, the marginal production would go on diminish. So this law states that when other things being equal, by keeping one or more factors constant, if we go on increase the remaining factors in variable proportions, after a stage, the marginal production would go on diminish. Clear? And we can observe three stages of production. We have to keep at least one or more factors constant, and we have to increase the remaining factors in variable proportions. Then the marginal production would go on diminish. First stage is increasing returns to scale. Increasing returns to scale. In this stage, the total production increases at an increasing rate. Total production increases at an increasing rate during first stage. It is increasing returns to scale. Then second stage is constant returns to scale. Constant returns or diminishing returns. Diminishing returns to scale. Here, total production increases at a diminishing rate. Third stage will be negative returns to scale. Here, total production starts to decrease. At that stage, the negative return starts. So these are the three stages of production: increasing returns, diminishing returns, and negative returns. Now the question is, why the total production or marginal production would go on diminish? The first reason is that all factors of production are in limited quantity. Then no factor has a perfect substitute. No factor has a perfect substitute. Another reason is every factor of production has its own capacity to produce. Beyond that limit, no factor can make further positive contribution. So after reaching its maximum capacity, no factor can contribute further the positive contribution to the total production. So these are the reasons. Therefore, after a stage, the marginal production would go on diminish if we vary some factors of production in variable proportions by keeping one or two factors constant. Now, what is the significance of this law? Just I have told you, it is a very important law of production, and also the fundamental law, and also the universal law. By analyzing this particular law, we can study very well the causes for diminishing returns. Causes for diminishing returns. And also we can prevent the diminishing returns. By improving technology, we can enjoy increasing returns instead of diminishing returns. Therefore, this law is very important. Every producer should possess the knowledge of this particular law while carrying his business, while carrying his production. He should know about this. In the short run, the diminishing return starts if we go and increase the variable factors in variable proportions by keeping some factors constant. Therefore, after a stage, marginal production would go on diminish. We can take several steps to prevent diminishing returns, and the producer can enjoy increasing returns instead of diminishing returns. Then what are the assumptions of the law? This law is based on certain assumptions. Firstly, at least one or more factors should be held constant. This is one. Either land or labor or capital or organization. One of the factors should be held constant and other factors should be varied in variable proportions. Then, this law is applicable only in the short run. Then, the third assumption is technology should remain constant. Then, fourth is cost of production should remain the same. Fifth assumption is the fixed factor should reach its maximum capacity. Then only, if you go and increase the variable factors in variable proportions, the marginal production would go on diminish. Fixed factor should reach its maximum capacity. After that, that is during third stage, the marginal production would go on diminish, where the producer has to get the negative returns to scale. So with all these assumptions, we can support the law of variable proportion. I will give you the input-output schedule in our next period. Let us identify all the three stages of production, and I will draw total production curve, marginal production curve, and average production curve. Let us study the relations between those curves also. Let us study the schedule and diagram in our next period. Okay. Thank you.